Well, hey there. I'm here with Steve Roberts. Steve, hello.
Hello, Brett. How are you?
I'm good. I'm excited to talk to you because you're bringing something to this that I want to be able to share with other members, because you recently just shared on one of our Facebook groups that you had your first $25,000 day. Not just that's fantastic, but also this was what we call a 4-minute mile moment for you, where the 4-minute mile is where you know, no one else thinks you can break it. Maybe sometimes you don't even think you can break the 4-minute mile. And when someone does, suddenly everyone starts saying that's possible. It's like, yes. Yeah. So the fact that you had your 4-minute mile by breaking the 25K, this is the biggest news of all, because now there's lots of benefits. There's your own benefit of you knowing, hey, I just did it. And then there's the benefit of other people saying, oh, it can be done. How do you feel, Steve?
Feel great that I've achieved that milestone, which I have never achieved before. I've never had a 25K day. That for me was an important moment because of the belief that I put in myself for 5 years that I was worth.
So it's the result. It's not just something that happened. It's the result of the preparation, probably mindset, then the physical actions of actually knowing how to do it, setting up a website, making an offer. It's things like that, how to sell, how to advertise, yes?
Yeah. So 5 years since I launched my first online coaching program, actually 7 years really, and just going back into a full-time job, part-time job, coming back into my business, trying to make a go of that, and then sort of getting pushed out of that again. The ecology piece wasn't working, so I was going back into full-time work. So that belief and putting everything else aside and going, this is it. This is what I'm doing. And then it really culminating in that moment where the client who I have for this 25K is a former employer of mine, but really keeping in touch over the last 7 years through my Facebook marketing stuff, my newsletters, my occasional text messages. And funny enough, it was a text message that he got from me, which prompted him to pick up the phone and go, I need help.
Now, hold on. It wasn't the first text message he'd gotten from you?
No, I'd sent many for the last 7 years.
Right.
And I didn't go away.
Yes.
So persistence. There's the story about Colonel Sanders knocking on 100 doors or how many knocked on, and finally someone bought his recipe.
Yeah. And so for the folks here watching this, I want you to notice the belief patterns here. See that? He's quoting Colonel Sanders. He's not giving up. It's texting. It's never letting up when other people would absolutely let up and move on, right? Interesting. All right. So then I don't know anything about how you made the $25,000. Please tell us.
Well, I have a framework for my 25K course.
I'll pause right there. You've created a course that's worth 25K.
Exactly. Yeah. I have a $5,000 course. It's a short course, 12 weeks. But now I've actually created a second one, which is the expert one. That's the one that you propagated for me about 3 or 4 months ago inside of our advanced training, which was fantastic. And I never forget, there's always someone willing to fly first class. There's always a premium customer. There's always someone who wants to fly Emirates, who wants the red carpet. This is the guy who likes that. And I know he has the potential, the financial capability to do that. So I went, right, I've got two programs. One is 5K. It's a fast one. It's only 12 weeks. But the other one, painting the future. Now, I think this is what you need best, is the way I was talking to him about. So I didn't want to go to just the 5K. I was committed to making sure it was a 25K. He couldn't get out of it.
Pause right there. So this is interesting. So the psychology here was the belief pattern that there is always a premium customer. For the viewer at home, there is always people who want to go faster, further, and are prepared and able to invest in themselves. So you create that, you create the solution, and then you have this commitment, as in you know this person well enough to know that's really the solution that's going to benefit them the most. Is that what it is?
It is, and I will get you up skiing in a day. Was also one thing that I remember you saying, is that you've got hell, paradise. This gentleman is not really capable physically at the moment. He wants to do a trip, in 6 months' time. So he wants to be able to walk. He wants to be functioning. He wants to be strong. So I also
he has a vision. So he has the vision of where he's going. This is good for a customer's point of view. They know what they want. There's a goal in mind, right? Mm-hmm.
And I was feeding that vision by saying, I didn't talk about all the work we need to do.
Right.
I just continued to keep that trip up there in the forefront of the call to say, this is where we want to get to. What are we doing when we get there? When we get off that boat at the Antarctica, what are you going to be doing? So I used future paradise as the anchor to that call. And it was right, we've got some work to do. And I paused and I really, for the first time, I just shut my mouth.
So the decision was in his court. He'd committed to the end result. You showed him you understood what he wanted to do and where he wanted to go. And then he had two choices, a faster program, lower ticket, or a higher ticket, but it solves the problem, not just now, but in the future as well. Yes?
Exactly.
And when the silence was broken, take me through it. What was it like?
I don't know if I can swear. How much is it? I said 25,000. F off. I paused again. I didn't say anything. Let the silence do the work. F off. My normal response would have been, well, you get this and you get this and you get this.
Yes.
But the new me, Brett, thanks to Growth Club and Fast Client Formula, and I've been with you since July. Actually, May the 6th, I've got it on my phone when I first listened to your webinar. Yes. Since then, I've intensely put a lot of time into this, but the old me would have gone, you get this, validating and justifying what I'm worth. Yeah. So I didn't do that.
That would have been hard. It would have been hard. Although you prepared for it mentally, that would have been hard to just sit back and just stay in the moment while there's silence, yes?
Yeah. But, and I just went, I'm worth this. If this person, any person had to employ me for a year, $500,000 would probably be okay. $1 million would be where would I sit? And I'm worth that. I'm of age, and I've spent 25 years in this industry, and that's a long time to be at your trade. So believing what I'm worth and knowing that I'm the solution to these problems that men face. To a degree, there's a fair bit of stuff that I can't do, the psychology stuff and a few things, but holus bolus, I think I've got it. I think I'm the right person for this particular client. So,
take note of the beliefs. Sorry to cut you off there, Steve, but take note of the belief patterns here. These are universal beliefs. Yeah, they're not exclusive to Steve. You want to adopt the belief patterns. This is critical. Think of this like it's how we build a castle. Everything that Steve's giving you here, the belief, is another brick. That's how we build this strong castle that can't be knocked over. It's brilliant. Well done, Steve.
I know what I'm worth, and I know what my value is. So there's two big beliefs patterns there that I've smashed through over the years, especially coming from a personal trainer, charging out $1 a minute, woohoo, $60 an hour, but it's not your 5K days or your 25K days. And it's not about money. It's about the challenge that I've really, really appreciated. But once you break down one wall, it's going to flow on. Once you run your 4 minute mile, then others are going to start coming because you'll start attracting that, and you'll get even more wiser about the way that you work through your sales conversations and calls, because paint the picture of where they're going to be, and then keep them to that. Don't go back to their hell because you already know that they don't want to be there. Pull them out of hell with your positivity and what you're going to be helping them achieve, where they're going to be, and then pause. Where do you want to go to from here?
Super simple. It's just that simple, really. So many people complicate it, but that really is as simple as it is. It's beautiful psychology. Well done. And in terms of, let's just try and help the viewer, in terms of the process, there was your prospect who was still a prospect. You texted him with a message. What roughly did that message say, Steve?
Hey, I'm running a challenge, a 5-day challenge. And if you're interested in losing up to 5 kilograms, let me know if this interests you. Something along the lines of that.
He texts back, yes?
He texts back and say, yes.
Then the next step?
Saturday, I don't care if it's the weekend, pick up the call. Sir, good to speak to you. Thanks for replying to my text message. What's going on? So I didn't go, oh, hang on, it's not Monday yet. I went, bang, human contact, that's what people need. We forget in the online world potentially that we start thinking we're keyboard people, we have to stay. No, no. Whenever it's up, this man had an emotional need, and I like to say that, well, I fulfilled that by going, righto, what's the problem right now? Let's talk about it now, and then let's line up a time where we can discuss this further in a brainstorming call, and then from there, I actually drove to the location where this gentleman lives, and eyeballed him face to face, and
wow.
went through it. Yeah, so I was very, very committed. And financially, I knew the man had the capability to do this sort of thing, but I wasn't afraid of rejection because I had nothing to lose.
Yes. And so the breakthrough call was done in person in this instance, yes?
Well, no, that was this was text message, yes. Brief phone conversation, then a bit of a brainstorm call, a bit about what I'm doing, because we haven't spoken for 6-7 years. And then the next one was a visit.
Yep.
To see the capability, and then get a bit of a clearer view of what this gentleman wanted.
He felt understood, right?
I really, really wanted to understand. And then I said, okay, great. I'm going to go away with this and I'm going to put together a plan for you. That conversation, Brett McFall, took place when I was in front of my laptop at McDonald's in Warwick on my way traveling south somewhere else. The gentleman was in Brisbane, so it was still online. And you can imagine you got your free Wi-Fi and McDonald's. Meanwhile, you got a mad background going on. But I was going somewhere else, so I still had my online hat on. Yep. But I did the process there and then. So I'll never forget the McDonald's in Warwick, Queensland.
Oh,
terrible
man.
Place. I'm a health expert, I know, but they get a coffee and something cheap.
And good Wi-Fi, probably. So, all right, very good. And then, all right, the call ends. And he's in, and describe your emotions.
I humbly felt very happy that I was going to be helping the man. Secondly, the belief that I knew was always there actually gave me a high five. And it was that was a really good proclamation, affirmations, all these things coming true, bubbling up and going, this is where you're meant to be, and this is why you didn't give up.
You did it. It's a key moment. You'll never forget it. And now he's not the only person that would be prepared to do what it takes to be in that solution, right? So many more out there. And now your business is basically blown wide open. Like, well, hold on. If I could find one of these premium customers once a week, it's a game changer, yes?
Yes.
And now it's just a matter of getting in front of more people. It comes down to one challenge now. How do I get in front of more people?
Well, this challenge that I ran, I had 5 people in it.
Yep.
It's like booking out a room.
Yeah.
But booking out a room is a bit more committed, right?
Yeah.
Free five-day challenge.
Done online. So this was online?
Yeah.
So he didn't even do the challenge, if I understand correctly. This customer didn't do the challenge.
No, that's right. Yeah. So sorry, this is following the challenge. It probably has nothing to do with it. But even since then, some other small ticket sales have been achieved through a 5-day challenge as well. So I've got a couple of leads going on really, and one's the 5-day challenge, free. They get to know, like, and trust.
Yep.
Very important. that's been a big thing for me in the online space, but also connecting with people and giving them that value. And then after that, I want to offer them, I do offer them a brainstorming call if they want to chat about their fitness program. From there, we can take it further into a strategy call, which is the big one, you know. So so I'm putting it out there, and that's what happens. People need help. And I don't want to him, it's like, as you've said before, it's like you don't want them to get run over by the bus. Sometimes you got to run in front of the bus and save them. And if you let them off the hook, then it could be bad.
Yeah, the psychology there being that if there was a child about to cross the road and you knew they were in danger about maybe being hit by a car, would you softly say, hey, you might want to think about not going on the road, or would you do whatever it takes to shout, to jump, to grab them so they didn't get go into that danger? And that's what this is all about. When you care enough about a customer, you don't just passively think, oh, well, that's okay. No, it's not okay. Because if you want to get to here, here, and here, here's what it takes. And that's that attitude, that tone of voice, that whole presence that that changes the game. It goes from being a sales call to being a life-changing conversation. Yeah,
and I didn't think this. There was no limitations on the wealth of the person. It was their belief in themselves that I had to help them with in that moment, because I think that might have been the game changer for this man. Because I think it was no doubt he had the financial capabilities, yep. but maybe not the mindset. So just there with a switch, right? Well, then, I can help you do this.
Good. And then there's the cost. There's a cost both ways. The cost if he didn't get help. He's got a plan, got to go overseas. He wants to go overseas, I believe, with what you're saying. So there's the cost of not being ready. And that's where everyone needs to remember that real transaction there, because there's a cost both ways. Cost getting help, cost not getting help. And when the cost getting help is a lower price than the actual cost of not getting help, game over. People are in, right? It's a good decision.
Yeah, and it's going to take longer. It's going to take longer if you do it on your own, and you might never do it on your own. It might be all just dreams and wishes that don't actually come to fruition if you don't get some serious help. Serious might be too much of a serious word, but if you want to use that, then that's how strongly committed I am to helping people on the call. You know, I don't know all the depths of people's psychology or what skeletons they have or vices they have problems with, and that will be unearthed once they become a client of yours if they want to let you in, but you have to have that trust and belief in knowing that you can get them to the place that they imagine that they could get to with your help.
Yeah, and their commitment, right? Their commitment to the self-improvement, to taking responsibility for the results. You take responsibility for the techniques, the strategy, the how-to. They take responsibility for actually making it happen, and you got a beautiful coaching relationship, yeah?
And I didn't go forward with the call until I really felt comfortable with the why.
Mm.
Mm. Why do you want this? Why? Why is that important? And how's that going to make you feel? How's that going to affect others? I continued on that. I think I felt like I was interrogating quite a fair bit, but it was a politely done interrogation of words, because I wanted to get them out from the back of the mind or wherever that was sitting, this person could not relay on to potentially other people, even very, very close to them. So the psychology in that was like, I'm here, I'm listening, you can get it out now and you can talk about it now.
For the first time ever, right?
Quite possibly.
Someone listening to that degree is a rarity. It virtually never happens. People asking that gentleman his why would literally have never happened before. If someone asked him once, okay, maybe there's a chance. But to keep on digging and actually going for the real reason, it never happens. This is what makes it a transformational call.
I'm not going to be a coach. I'm not going to know if I don't know. So I have to have it there, you know, available to use back against them if I need to. But then secondly to that is that once they're in, we can keep going back. This is why. This is why. This is why. This is why. Remember. So I've learned a lot about being a coach, but also from the Growth Club calls have been great. Getting new information. You throw everything at us, Brett. You're truly genuine, great coach and mentor. So I really appreciate it. I appreciate the belief and you not giving up as well.
Oh man, super honored, completely honored that you have put such effort in. It makes my day. This is what I, you know, you go back to what, why am I doing this? This is literally it. This is it. Like this is, you know, I most coaches, the money can be good, but it just becomes numbers in the bank account. Literally doesn't have a whole lot of value, long-term value. It's this is when someone actually breaks through. It's like you get goosebumps and there's nothing quite like it. Steve, congratulations once again. Brilliant work. And even better, you're prepared to share it here to help others, to inspire others, to show them that the 4-minute mile has been crossed. And if it can, if, you know, if I can do it, you can do it type of thing. It's brilliant. What would be your last bit of advice? The most important thing that someone watching this needs to know, maybe doesn't know, or maybe doesn't want to know. If you could shake them and say, you know what you need to do? This is it. Go.
When a job is once begun, leave it not till it's done. Be it large, be it small, do it well, but not at all. But that's an old saying, of course. But I always believe that hard work pays off, and you just got to keep opening the doors. You've got to keep knocking on the doors and reaching out because there's always someone who needs your help. I can help someone right now improve their life.
Yeah,
I can do it better face-to-face, but I really had to break through that belief that I can do it even better online. So it was really my own self-belief as well that I had to get through. If you're listening right now, you have the ability and the coaching principles, the experience, bring that into your personal calls with your potential clients and help first. Coach second, help first.
Yeah, beautiful. Steve, thank you very much. Well done. And we can't wait to hear more. And I wish you all the very best.
Thank you, Brett.